My name is Devin Carroll. I am originally from central Massachusetts in a little town called Lunenburg, pretty rural. I went to undergrad at UMass Amherst and then came on down here to work with Professor Markiam in ModLab. And we've been studying reconfigurable and modular robotics ever since. StickBot is a robotic system that is intended to provide users with a large amount of flexibility at an extremely low cost. And we do that by leveraging the modularity of found materials. We have a bunch of tree branches or sticks, and we're able to assemble them into truss structures in different configurations. And in doing so, we can get things like a crawler robot or a gripper robot, or really anything you can imagine. Similar to StickBot, IceBot is a modular robot made from ice, however, no longer tree branches, strictly ice. Once again, the idea being extreme modularity in remote or inhospitable places. The trick with IceBot is, where do you apply it? Where can it be used? And the two solutions are usually Antarctica or an icy moon like Enceladus. Another challenge with that, in addition to where do you apply it, is how do you integrate actuators into the ice? And with ice, it's pretty straightforward. You drill a hole, and then you put the motor in, and then you pack it and freeze it. You can't do that with sticks. But can we do something else, i.e. lashing? So I guess really the lessons learned from IceBot was, don't be afraid to try crazy things. It might just work. I grew up on a farm in rural Massachusetts. We raised sheep. We hayed, we recycled, we had a solar system. Everything we did was intended to be renewable. And when you threw things away, that was not necessarily frowned upon, but nor was it considered a good thing. We see StickBot as fulfilling a need. The biggest thing is, I think, rehabilitation. And specifically, affordable global healthcare. When you get to these low and middle income countries, things are much more expensive. And by using the modularity and the reconfigurability, we can address different things like rehabilitation. One of the medical procedures they do is they use an ergometer, which is essentially a cycling device. And you pedal, and that helps you recover from strokes or something similar. And that's all well and good, but you have to get it to the site. And once it breaks, how do you fix it? So if we could deploy the robotic system that is StickBot in a scenario such as that, suddenly we can help a lot more people. And in doing so, you just make a difference.